Hello and welcome to techsith tutorials. Today we are going to learn about function mixins in JavaScript. Now the big question is, what are mixins? Well, the original concept came from an ice cream shop. Yes. I got hungry just preparing for this video, so I thought I'll get an ice cream. So the original concept came from an ice cream shop where he was providing users or customers with this option to add mixins in his in their ice creams. So basically you would take vanilla ice cream, you pick one ice cream, vanilla, chocolate, whichever you like, and then there'll be a bunch of toppings. So they're not just toppings that you put it on the top. You basically pick your toppings like almonds and chocolates or cookie, whatever, and then he'll smash all those toppings into the ice cream and then create your own flavor. So that's what the mixins are. In terms of JavaScript mixins, in programming sense, mixins are this piece of code that you actually add it to your objects to extend them. So your objects will have functionality of those mixins. Basically, you can borrow functionality from different mixins to build your own object. Now, let me first finish before we start the tutorial. So let's try to understand how to build a mixin. For example, if I want to build a chocolate chips ice cream with almonds, I would have to have vanilla ice cream with some chocolate chips and some almonds. So I have two mixins that I'm mixing in with this ice cream. So let's say if I want to build a JavaScript engineer, so what I would have to do is I can make all the JavaScript skills as one mixin and the engineering degree as a second mixin, so that I can make a JavaScript engineer. And I can use an object or assign method to mix them together. So let's start with the JavaScript skill, mixin. So I would say const js skill equal to, it's an object with one method called knowsJS. And inside it would say return true. Now let's build a degree object. So I can say const engineering degree equal to has degree method which returns true. Again, I'm building very simple so that you would understand it. So let's say if I want to compose a JavaScript engineer, I would do simply this. I would say const js engineer equal to object dot assign, and I would pass two arguments. The first argument, it's going to be an empty object, so this is our vanilla, and then I would mix in the JS skill and engineering degree. Now if you don't know what the object assign does, I have a tutorial on it. Previous tutorial we learned about the object or assign method. I'll provide a link here. But what it basically does is it would take the first argument, which is an empty object, and it would take this two, JS skill and engineering degree, and it would mix in together. So this empty object would have all the functions of JS skills and engineering degree, which means it will have this two function, knowsJS and has degree. So if I look at this object, console.dir js engineer, I would see the object, and if I expand it, it has two methods, has degree and knowsJS. Let's say if I want to build a full stack engineer, then I would need another object called backend skill, and it would say knows backend, which will return true. And here I can build another object called const full stack engineer equal to object dot assign, and it would have the empty object. And since the full stack engineers can do back end and front end, which means he or she knows JavaScript and one of those back end programming languages like Java, so it would say JS skill back end skill, and also has engineering degree. So here I have our full stack engineer. So if I take the full stack engineer and then run the three methods, knows JavaScript, and run it, I would get true for each. So this was a simple example of how mixings work. So now, in order to understand function mixins, which are made of factory functions, so let's understand what factory function is before we go into the function mixins. Now, there are two ways to build objects. Either you can use a constructor, like we looked at in the first chapter of this series, or you can use a factory function. So the constructor would be something like this function, and let's say car equal to a function, and it would have some argument, and inside you would say this dot color equal to color. So this is a constructor, and you can use it like let red car equal to new. You have to use a new keyword and red. But the factory functions are like regular functions, and so the way it would work is instead of this inside here, object dot assign, and then I would take an empty object, again what we did before, and then have color equal to color. So basically it would take an empty object, and then whatever the argument pass, it sets a property and it returns it. And here, instead of new car, you would just say run like a regular function, and it would return this newly created function. And I can also have a factory function with a state preserve, basically have a closure inside. So what I would have to do is have an inner variable. So let's say it's a car, so I can have a variable called moving equal to false, which means by default the car is not moving. And inside here I can add two methods. One is drive, which will move the car. So then I can say moving equal to true, and I can have another function that checks if it's moving or not, called is moving, which simply returns. So here, if I now look at the car object, a red car object, for example, I said return, I would see an object with color red, and it has two methods, drive and is moving. And if I look at the each method, I would see the scope, and it would have a closure which holds the moving equal to false here, and also is moving also the same way, it would have the closure, and it would preserve this moving variable. So this is basically caching the variable inside. So I can call something like this. I can say red car dot drive, and I can say is moving. So first it would make the moving equal to true, and then I can check if it's moving or not. First I have to say return this here, so it would return me the object again. So now if I run it, I would get true, which means it's moving. So this is an example of factory function with closure. All right, so now we can build our function mixins. So function mixins are nothing but this factory function that takes an object as an argument, and it would copy the methods that are inside the mixins into this object and returns a new object. So that is what function mixin is, and the state is basically preserved because as we looked at the factory function with closure. So let's say if I want to build a Superman. Superman has two abilities, human abilities, even though he's an alien. He's got human abilities and he's got a Superman ability, which means he can cry, he can breathe like other humans, but he can fly and he can dodge bullets like aliens. So we can have two mixins. One would be human factory and a second would be flying factory. So let's build a human factory first. So I would say const human factory equal to, it's a function and it takes object as an argument. Again, this is the object that it would take and it would add all these methods. So it would have a variable called is crying equal to false. So I'm just gonna talk about only one ability of human is to cry. So all human cry and he will cry too. And it would return this object using object.assign. So I would take an empty object. Then I would take the object that I'm passing in. And then I would add the methods that this factory would provide. And the reason I am always using the empty object as the first argument is because I want to create a completely new object. Because the job of the factory is to create new objects. If I just copy these methods into the object that I'm passing in, then I'm actually passing the same object out. And I don't wanna do that. That's why I wanna create new object every time. And that's the purpose of object factory is, function factory is. So here I will have two methods. One method is going to be cry, which will make is crying equal to true. When you start crying, it makes the is crying equal to true. And then it will check if somebody is crying, which will just simply returns is crying. Which means if I just create a human called, let's say, techsith me equal to human factory, and I'll just pass in empty object. And if I examine console.dir techsith, I always make this mistake, turn, I would see an object which has two methods, cry and is crying. And again, inside you would have a closure with is crying equal to false. Now let's build another factory called fly factory. So const fly factory equal to a function, which will take an object just like before, flying equal to false. And it would return object.assign, It would pass the first empty object, then the object, and then a bunch of methods that it would implement. So fly first, that would just makes the is flying equal to true. And it would have another method called is flying, which would just return is flying. Now let's build our Superman. So what I will do is I would first do fly factory, and I would pass an empty object, and that would return me the fly factory with is flying equal to false, and it would have two methods, right? Now I would pass that into human factory as an argument. So I would say human factory. So this would add two more methods, cry and is crying, and it would return some object, and I would call it Superman. So if I look at the Superman, I would have all the four methods, and you would see the state preserved inside the closure of each function. I can make the Superman fly. So I would say Superman.fly. Well, I have to call return this here, so I can chain all the objects. If you don't know what method chaining is, I have a tutorial on it. I'll provide a link. So first you fly, then you cry. So they're both flying, is flying and is crying becomes true. And then I can actually check if is crying. So this should return me true. So if I check console log, oh, here I need to also say return this, so that it would return the entire object so I can chain it. And now if I click here, it would give me true. And subsequently, if I say console log Superman dot, it should be is flying. So both are true. So that means Superman is flying and crying at the same time. So that concludes our Mixin tutorial, and all the code sample we looked at today, I will be putting into on the techsith article. I'll provide a link here, and I will also provide a link to translation. I know a lot of my viewers are outside US and they are looking in different languages. So please, if you can translate for me, that'd be great. Especially Hindi, because a lot of my viewers are from India. I would really appreciate it. And I hope you learned something from this tutorial. And if you did, please like, subscribe, and provide a constructive comment. Thank you.